You, come closer. Your captain needs you. One of those blasted things jabbed me. In a bad way. That demon storm. The voice in my head. These foul creatures. I don't know what the hell's going on here. I think so. I could have sworn I saw one of the Swabbies. But it was one of those creatures. Damned priest. I never should have trusted that bastard. All his talk of legends and power, treasures. Nothing but lies. And the bar. I don't know. I lost it when the ship went down. But this voice, she says I need to get it back. You! I order you. Search the beach. If we don't recover the box. No. Wait. I will find it. No. Please. I can't die here. Not like this.
Wash up on my shore, exhausted and weak, and I welcome you home. My destiny to claim that. The choice. You forced my hand. Your soul is now mine.
Within me, everlasting glory will be ours.
Thank you. Steady there, friend. Dying can be a rather harrowing experience the first time one goes through it. You're actually looking quite healthy, all things considered. Luckier than most. Not anymore, but you were very much dead for a few minutes there. You've been resurrected, you see. It's quite a lot to take in, I know. You'll find many strange things on Eternum, and this not-dying business is one of them. Yes, the pole of the corruption. It's that damn storm. I can't even count the number of ships it's wrecked. And every sailor coming ashore is corrupted. You're one of the few who came through with your soul intact. Ah, but I forget my manners. Watcher Layson Reese, at your service. I watch these shores for shipwrecks and help those like yourself. You're undoubtedly quite shaken by all of this, and probably famished too. Resurrection is taxing on the soul and the body. Ah. Unfortunately, we don't keep the watchtower very well stocked. Bring your own mead, is the rule. But there are some nice fat boar roaming around nearby. Of course, you're not exactly equipped for hunting, are you? Yes, you'll need a skinning knife to start. Unless you prefer your roasted boar with the skin on. If you'll gather some flint and wood on your way to join me at the watchtower, you can fashion a crude knife at the campfire. Impressive. One of the nicest crude skinning knives I've seen. You've done this before, haven't you? It's important to know how to provide for yourself here. The wilds of Eternum can be a very harsh environment. It's reasonably safe up the road in the town of Pridewin, but out here, we are on our own. Yes, it has its own share of troubles, but nothing like what we are seeing here. The persistence of this storm is worrisome, to say the least. I may very well need your help, but as I promised, we need to get you fed first. Yes, you'll find them snuffling around in the bushes nearby. They're ornery, but I think you can handle it. Go and hunt yourself down a fat one, skin it, and cook yourself a little feast at the campfire. Smells delicious! And you seem to be feeling better than when you first rejoined the ranks of the living. That's convenient, because I really do need your help to make sure the threat here on the shore is contained. We get shipwrecks on these shores now and then, but I've never seen anything like this. The storm, all these ships, and the fact Everyone's corrupted except you? Well, we have to do something. That's the dark side of eternal life, I suppose. You resurrected with your soul intact, but many come back soulless. The lost. Or worse, they return with their souls twisted, possessed by insatiable evil. Those we call the corrupted. Essentially, yes. And the corrupted are relentless, destroying and killing to increase their numbers. Looking at the wreckage of your ship, I suspect that's what's become of the rest of your crew. It's just across the water, and frankly, we need to deal with the corrupted gathering there. I know it's not a pleasant task, but if you can put down some of your former crewmates, it's a start, at least. Oh, excellent! If the corrupted start converging on you in numbers, I suggest you retreat. Either way, keep that blade handy. The last thing we need is for you to be joining their ranks.
They shall ruthlessly strike down their fellows. Their path to corruption begun.
Well done. It's grim work. The storm wall is a fact of life here. It completely surrounds the island, wrecking any ships that approach and any that attempt to leave. But this storm, it's unnatural even by Eternum standards. There must be something, or someone, causing it. I'm not sure. But all this wreckage at the same time. It seems like it must be coordinated somehow. We generally see a new shipwreck only once a season. And even then, there are usually more survivors. Ah, that's likely a lost cause. If they're out there, stuck in the midst of the wreckage, they're probably already corrupted. More importantly, I need to focus on finding the storm's source, and I couldn't possibly ask you to go alone. Well, I fear you may not fully grasp the danger of such an endeavor, But I won't hold you back. Just keep that weapon at the ready, and take out as many corrupted as you can. If you find survivors, send them here.
This is only the beginning. All these sailors join our cause. Soon, we'll be all of humanity.
On the sand. You have my thanks. I know a safe spot this way. Come on. Tell you what a relief it was seeing someone who was still human. I was beginning to think I was all alone out here. The rest of the world had gone mad. Perfect. I was betting there'd be some kind of town nearby. Thinking I'd go look for it after I'm done out here. But I'm not about to go walking away from a fleet of freshly crashed boats. Not if I have a choice in the matter. This isn't my first shipwreck, you know. One thing I've learned, you have to always think ahead, keep an eye on the horizon. And there's booty to be had here. Countless treasures captain and crew had stashed on board, if you know where to look. Of course! Not like these rotters care a damn for it, and I'll be needing a new ship, a new crew. That takes coin. In fact, if you want to partner up, I'd spit the loose 70-30. Or what the hell, 60-40 even. What do you say? Then we can go head to that watchtower of yours. That's the spirit. It's a deal. I need to circle back to my own ship to grab what I can. But there's a wreck over there I haven't searched yet. Find the manifest first, then look for whatever's listed. I'll meet you over there. Fortune smile on you, mate.
Shall steal from one another like rats fighting over scraps. Thank you.
to worry. More important, unfortunately, I didn't have as much luck as you did. Those damn red-eye rotters are swarming all over the wreckage of my ship. I worry it's bad luck leaving behind my own treasures, but I can't get through the bastards. Now there's a good mate. Tough one too, if you're so confident. No complaints, though. Tell you what, if you can get my stuff back, I'll give you a greater share of our profits. 40-60. Or what the hell, 30-70. What do you say? Most of our cargo was lost at sea, and I got my captain's log on the way out. What's burning me now is leaving behind my ship's flag and my lucky wheel. Get those, and then maybe we meet at that watchtower. Works for me.
Welcome back, my friend. Glad to see you're still with us. I was elated to meet another survivor, but I feared we lost you in the process. Oh, Grace O'Malley. A real piece of work, isn't she? Can't say I would have wanted to make that trade. While you were away, I think I may have located the source of this endless storm. There's a network of sea caves nearby, where the corrupted seem to be gathering. Something nefarious is going on in there. I feel certain of it. See? Now there's someone willing to step up. I can't do this alone. I thought perhaps our new friend might join as well, but she's not really the joining type, is she? I suspect you'll be wasting your breath, but give it a go. Why not, right? I'll go ahead and scout out the entrance to the caves. Whether she comes or not, I'll meet you there.
Look, I'm as grateful as can be that you reclaim my flag and all. But don't ask me to go on a fool crusade against those red-eyed demons. I don't need a medal of valor. Just a coin for me, thank you very much. Good old Watcher Layson Reese says there's a town. I'll head there and sell this loot. I'll set your part aside until you get there. For my part, I'll be saving up for a ship to escape this hellish island. Oh, I heard a lot of stuff from Watcher Layson Reese, but I don't believe even half of it. Besides, Captain Grace O'Malley never met a storm she couldn't navigate. I'll find a way. You can come with me, if you like. Have it your way, hero. I just hope you don't end up as one of those monsters yourself. Don't worry about me burning you on the loot. You did me a favor, and I'm good for it. As long as you survive, that is. I'll be there.
Hey, you gave it a try, at least. Ugh, that Grace O'Malley's a pirate to the bone. Doesn't care about anyone but herself. Looking at the corrupt amassing here, however, neither her nor anyone else will be safe if this keeps up. The storm is centered right above these caves. No doubt about it. I suspect some foul magic is afoot in there. The place reeks of charred bones and unbridled brutality. I don't know. If we both fall in there, there'll be no one to get word to town. I certainly don't trust that pirate to do so. I say we head back to town and recruit as many sword arms as we can, and then come back. Damn it! I'd forbid it. But I fear you're right. Their numbers are growing too fast. Go then, but be quick about it. Look for the source of the storm and destroy it. I'll meet you back at the watchtower. Godspeed, my friend.
They shall witness the power manifest, the true future of the human race.
Ah!
steal that which is mine? You assault my followers, and now you disrupt my plans. This is personal.
When I saw the storm receding, I knew you had triumphed. What was in there? Some kind of abomination? A corruption rift? Oh, I've heard legends of such things from way back. And you disrupted it. That's a story fit for legend right there, I'd say. You have no idea what a relief this is. I didn't want to sound pessimistic, but nothing like this has happened in the 300 years I've been here. Those who've been here longer, the ones who haven't been driven mad by all the years, they tell horror stories about the corrupted. It seems that centuries ago, some dark sorcerer nearly corrupted everyone on the island. I suspect we'll see more corrupted in the future, but let's hope we can prevent such darkness as the legends speak of. Still, I'll write a report for the town. Tell them the storm's receded, but to remain vigilant. I hate to ask you to be the bearer of bad tidings, but I should stay here. Just deliver the report to the guard at the gate. Then get yourself a nice cup of mead at the tavern. You deserve it.
Come closer. It is time you know the whole truth. This island has always guarded the promise of paradise. Humanity cast out, deemed unworthy of such blessings. But I did not come here seeking paradise. I came for answers. Redemption after a life of weakness and suffering. And I found a truth that disproved everything I had been taught. I tasted the knowledge forbidden to us at creation, and I saw the vision of humanity's true potential. I knew then, I must correct this ancient injustice. And restore the power which is rightfully ours. The heart of the mountain now beats strong with this purpose. After a century of preparation, our campaign has begun. The island's townships already fall before the might of our armies. The only thing I had not foreseen is you. You, who have stolen the gift meant for me. And now your soul will pay the price. For I will not stop until I have seized back the destiny stolen from us and brought true freedom to the world, both old and new.
Did you see my cart? Huh? The wild. wilds of Eternum have never been safe. But the roads? Never seen anything like this before today. Vicious boars came out of nowhere, ate all me truffles. How should I know? Do I look like some kind of boar mind reader? Not me. I'm just a simple traveling herbalist. Tell you this much, however, the beasts have ruined me for the season. You mean you'd help old hapless Hal? Why, yes, you're a saint. Take my sickle, hunt up some truffles, and bring them to the settlement. Gather any herbs or berries you see for yourself as well. They'll fetch a gold or two at the trading post.
Welcome to Pridewyn, founded during the reign of the High King, a legacy honored to this day. A report from Watcher Reese. Thank you. So, it was foul corruption behind the storm? In his report, Watcher Reese acknowledges your heroism. In which case, you belong here. Pridewyn has a strong tradition of heroes. Of course, we always welcome guests, and you've arrived at a most fortuitous occasion. Why, we have just learned the true heir to the throne is returning to the region. This is a day we have been awaiting for centuries, and a sign of new hope even during these troublesome times. Oh, I could recount the legends for days, but I must dispatch someone to the shore now. The Night Regent is indisposed, but Minister Lochnir runs day-to-day affairs in Pridewyn.
Here's my new friend right here! All the truffles I lost and then some! Hoo-hoo! I hope it wasn't too hard. Keep that sickle for your troubles, and if you make a habit of harvesting herbs and such, we'll cross paths again. No doubt.
Well now, two new faces to Pridewyn in one day. Many a year since I've seen that. But these are special times. After centuries, the true heir returns, and the royal bloodline will once again sit upon the throne. Forgive me, I take it for granted all are aware. The heir is Sir Gawain himself, most gallant of the High King's Knights. You will have the honor to see his homecoming and the return of Pridewyn's glory after many dark years. Across the centuries, I've watched the light fade from Monarch's bluffs in the absence of a true ruler. Of course, the Night Regent has done all she can with my wise counsel, and now our patience will soon be rewarded. Only a matter of days. I'm personally attending to preparations even now, as is my duty. Tradition is everything, wouldn't you say? One such custom I've established is that we offer our guests a complimentary room at the inn. You'll find the inn quite hospitable. I hand-selected the innkeep a few decades ago, so by all means, check in and have a warm meal by the fire. I must attend to other matters now, but we will speak again.
Corruption will claim them all. Warning them is a futile effort. They are blind to the real danger all around them.
Welcome to the Regent's Rise. Sleep here and wake up feeling like a king. You here to check in? Be my guest. Ooh, literally.
Familiar face. About time you caught up. Here we find ourselves in a little village pulled straight from the Middle Ages. Is it me? Or does nothing on this island make any sense at all? No doubt. For a place where everyone gets eternal life, you'd think it'd be more calm, dull even. Not saying I'd like that, mind you. One thing that is the same, though, is cold, hard coin. You have it or you don't. Makes all the difference. bit light in the pocket, but I did sell that loot we collected, so there's your share. Never let it be said Grace O'Malley doesn't pay her debts. Well, you got that coin I just gave you, so I'd suggest you get to spending it. Buy yourself a new blade, some new boots, whatever suits your fancy. Ah, yeah, there's a trading post out there. Livelier market than I would have expected. You should check out the trading post yourself, and if you need to stash anything, there's a storage shed too. Go on, I'll be here. Look at you! Here just a few hours and you're already the most popular person in town. You had a caller while you were out. That overly chipper knight from the town gate dropped by. Says he wants to have a word with you. That Sir Payne and Minister Lochnear talk this place up like it's got a grand history and a bright future. But I'm not buying it. Word in the tavern is that Pridewind's overrun with people fleeing from trouble at the outlying farms. Sounds like some kind of plague. People turning on their friends and neighbors with cold murder in their eyes. Unlike those red-eyed bastards on the beach, these folks aren't possessed. Seems like they don't have any souls at all. I didn't trust all the shite coming out of that watcher's mouth, but maybe there was some truth to it. Ask Sir Payne about these soulless lost outside town. Maybe get a more honest idea of what's happening here.
Excellent to see you again. Perhaps Miss O'Malley can be trusted after all. As to you, however, the Watcher's report guarantees it. In fact, the Night Regent would like to discuss a rather delicate situation, if you're willing. Oh, so you have heard the unfortunate news from outlying areas. I'm sorry to hear that. We try not to worry newcomers with such things, but we've even had some knights who failed to report in. Yes, well, I hope... well, I mean, I have the utmost confidence this will be cleared up before the heir arrives. I think the Night Regent simply wants to take precautions. Please speak with her when you can.
Come in and be welcome. I will never forget the way this island tested me when I first arrived. I strive to ensure we are patient with newcomers. And in these times, our customs are even more difficult to observe. That is good to hear. I believe Sir Payne represents us well, and the spirit of everything Pridewind stands for. However, with with all the anticipation surrounding Sir Gawain's return, we risk letting our optimism turn into denial. For weeks now, we've heard horror stories from people fleeing the farms, grieving the loved ones that turned on them. Behind their words, I sense a suppressed longing to surrender their own souls to despair. We offer shelter, comfort, and we dispatched knights to secure the roads, and many never returned. Minister Lochner counsels patience. He believes the royal bloodline will solve all problems, but I feel I must act. The mines are the backbone of Prideven, where many townspeople earn their livelihoods. I've had no reports in days. I simply ask you visit and confirm with Foreman Alia that all is well. Then report back to me, please.
Hearing about? Yes, you must be. You match the description. People talk around here, you know. They say you've been quite a help, and I was like, well, why haven't they helped me? But then I realized, silly Geerty, it's because you haven't asked. Yes, honey. Honey so delicious, it's called Devil's Honey. I have a special reserve up on Hyriath Lookout. Collect my honeycombs, and I'll give you some to taste.
Love keeps you warm, but so does wool. Come to me if you ever need something stitched. I've made a fair garment for many a fine folk, even my darling Eddie. Who isn't back yet? Yes. My foolish heart can't help long for my Eddie. He toiled too hard in the mines. This is the first time he's missed our anniversary. I'd go to the mines myself, but his favorite turkey is roasting away. That'd be lovely. Tell that Ulf he has a wife who loves him more than the mines do. And then, gently remind him that it's our anniversary today. And I'll be very cross if he doesn't have a gift for me.
Thank you. Whoa, you! If you thought you were going to the mine, think again. If you have loved ones in there, I don't know what to tell you. Most everyone's fallen lost. And no support from White One in sight. Oh, so now she sent someone. And a stranger who's not here in the night. Cha. I sent missive after missive to the minister. And I think I said, send every night available. Doesn't look like that's what's happening. For a while, some of the miners were holding out, fighting back with their picks against the teeth and claws of their now withered friends. At this point, it's probably a lost cause. I can't imagine that any of them are still standing. Oh, you're brave. I'll give you that. But we're not talking about a handful of withered. We're talking about the whole damn mine. If you go in there and find anyone, I'll get them out of there. Fast.
Never get out of here. Thank you.
Here! Oh, finally, a sign of hope. A brave warrior battling their waste with a withered. Oh, it's beyond a relief to see you up here. Now maybe we can find a way to reclaim the mine. And for that, I'm mighty grateful, sure enough. But I believe I may have found the source of this terrible curse. You've got to see for yourself. This whole thing started when we found a damn tablet deep in the mine. Someone had tried to make it look like it was just unearthed, but I know the look of freshly cut stone, and it wasn't fresh. I'm sure of it. The damn thing was making some unearthly sound. Not a one of us would touch it. The next day, we had lost pirates jumping down from the rocks, and then everyone started falling lost. Well, I'm no sorcerer, but that tablet's what started all this. No doubt about it. We need to destroy the damn thing. And maybe gather any fragments and take them back to Prydwen. There's smart people there. Sure enough. I'm not looking to linger here with pirates and withered swarming all over. Break that tablet and who knows? Maybe all those lost will disperse. Either way, I'll go. You have my word. God's blood! I didn't think you could actually pull it off, but you did! Though, it seems my hope of the lost leaving the mine won't be happening anytime soon. A promise is a promise. You held up your end of the bargain, so it's my turn. I'll go, but I swear one thing. I'll be coming back to reclaim this place as soon as we get the lost out. You did all the work, so I'll let you have the honor of bringing whatever remains of that tablet back to Prydwen. There's sages and people of that sort who can make sense of them. Oh, ask the Night Regent. She'll know. Oh, the Foreman's a stubborn one, and I'll wager she's still waiting at the mine's entrance. I'll go tell her there's none left to save, and then I'll see you in town. I'll even buy you a round at Gertie's.
Thank you.
Welcome to the Regent's Rise. Sleep here and wake up feeling like a king. You here to check in? Be my guest. Ooh, literally.
He's not with you. That can only mean... Blast that Dummkopf! I told him to stay with me today. But no, he had to go to the mines and pick at another rock. I'm sorry, too. There will never be another Eddie. I remember the first time he handed me his coat in the rain. Our first... Thank you for bringing me the news. Even if it wasn't what I expected.
Have my friendship, Rajal Sadak, and my time, and an odd job if you ever have need of one. We are always on the lookout for honest, hard-working people, and you strike me as being one. Let me give you a tip, Rajal Sadak. No one cares where you came from. We care about what you can do. The Regent made me her master builder after she saw my work. Though, she probably regrets that now. Well, I've run into some supply troubles. I was expecting a shipment of stone, timber, and leather this week. Nothing's turned up yet. I fear the poor souls I found to help me may have turned into the lost. Oh? Would you? That it be most excellent. You'd need to cut trees to gather wood and crush rocks to extract stone. There's a lot to teach you. But you seem up to the task.
Honey? I mean, my honeycombs. I wasn't calling you my honey. That would be absurd, but yes, this is fantastic. I'm gonna whip us up some honey cakes right away. You did me a good turn with my devil's honey. I'm thinking I might have another favor to ask, if you've got the time. Seeing as how everyone is talking about battening down the hatches here to protect against the lost, I think we need to stock up on spirits. And I think I might know a spot to get our hands on some perfectly aged wine from the old world. Bessid Shore, grab as many jars of wine as you can find there. We'll celebrate a little while we still have the time. Who knows what'll happen tomorrow?
Come, Seeker. Danger abounds, but your fortune will be grown. The lost banished, peace found, when the true heir takes the throne. Mountain and dale speak the tale, a warrior of wit and renown. Artorias raised them strong and brave, a true heir for his crown. For the heir, bring flowers fair, that we may build a path of blooms. May they know their people care. It is them we choose.
Mm-hmm.
glad to see you returned safely. Not long after you departed, I finally heard the news. Tell me though, is it as bad as they say? Surely some of the miners made it out. I can't tell you how disappointed I am to hear that. I have failed in my duty to protect the people of Pridewen. The warnings were there, and I allowed them to be ignored. From this moment forward, I will take every precaution to ensure the people of Pridewen are safe, inside and outside these walls. We will start by discovering how this disaster at the mine began. Surely someone saw something. A mysterious tablet in the mines? These fragments appear to be ancient in origin. I'm no expert, but I will consult the sage, Young Geezer. In the meantime, I need to know how the mine fell without my knowledge. Really? She said that? There's only one conceivable explanation for me not receiving the missives. Minister Lochner must have been keeping such reports from reaching my desk. That's a very good question. Perhaps it slipped his mind with all the preparations for Sir Gawain. I should allow him to clarify this point. Would you mind seeking him out? Then perhaps we'll all talk.
Newcomer returns. I understand the Night Regent dispatched you to the mines. A lot to ask of a guest, but it's her prerogative. Do tell, though. I hope the situation there wasn't as dire as it sounded. Oh yes, I am well aware. I received those missives myself. The foremen wanted us to send all our knights to help defend the mines, but that was, of course, impossible. With all the preparations for the return of the true heir, we simply can't dispatch our knights everywhere they're needed. I was preparing to send a few knights, but then I was told that you had been given the task. Oh, by all means, tell her I will come as soon as I finish my vital work on behalf of the true heir, which was proceeding apace before I was interrupted. Tell her it won't be long, and thank you for your service to Pridewen.
Return, but without Minister Lochner. I assume he claimed he was too busy with his preparations. Perhaps it's just as well. As Knight Regent, it may be best if I handle matters personally going forward. While you were away, Foreman Musa visited and related the whole story from the mines. She says the day after the mysterious tablet appeared, lost pirates attacked the mines, seemingly out of nowhere. These pirates could only have come from the Beseth shore to the north. There was a den of brigands there, and now they are apparently lost. This seems to be an alarming trend, and we must find the source of it. I have already dispatched Sir Payne to the north, which is my duty as Knight Regent. Lochner will not be pleased, but perhaps he will now deign to pay me a visit. You are eager and courageous, and it is most welcome. My hope is that you and Sir Payne can deter the pirates from further incursions, and discover what drives them. May fortune go with you both.
you to join us, my valued friend. I could have you to join us, my valued friend. I heard about your heroics at the mine. You definitely have the makings of a knight. For now, we are simply grateful to have your support. Not quite a full contingent here, I'm afraid. Before you do anything else, you must build yourself a campsite. It's the wise move when we're this far from Prideland. There's a splendid spot nearby. Set your tent, relax a bit if you like. We'll be here. Ah, you're back. I'm at a bit of a loss here. Oh, a few months ago, this barren beach had nothing but a smattering of pirates. Now, it appears to be a war camp, with more pirates and supplies arriving by the minute. Indeed. It's going to take an army to drive them out, and we currently lack an army. Perhaps we should pursue a more honorable approach to resolving this conflict. You two stay here and defend our position. I will go forth and challenge the leader of the pirates to a duel. When I am victorious, I will demand that they withdraw from these shores forthwith, never to return. Yes, good point. I suppose then we have a more limited set of options. I'm afraid I'm not much of a strategist in a scenario like this. What do you think would be most prudent? Oh, that's a grand idea! They've been unloading cargo using the smaller rowboats. If you can destroy the anchors and set the boats adrift, that would slow them down. I'll stay and keep an eye out for their leader.
Oh.
Oh, bravo, my bold friend! I feared the pirates would overwhelm you, but it seems you are nigh unstoppable. With their supplies cut off and boats adrift, their ability to wage war will be severely diminished. Oh, believe it or not, while you were battling on the beach, we apprehended an enemy spy. We all saw Miss O'Malley in Pridewen, and now we caught her skulking out of the pirate's lair. She insisted she was here scouting the place for her own ends. I find that extremely hard to believe. Look at her, looking all suspicious. But, I suppose if you're willing to vouch for her, we should at least hear what she has to say.
I've watched these rotters. I know what's driving them, making them go mad. If this sod didn't have his head up his arse, I could have already told you everything you need to know. I'll tell you, but if you go in, I'm expecting some loot. There's some kind of altar in there, glowing like a beacon. The bastards are drawn to it like flies to a carcass. I'd wager they'll wander off if you smash the damn thing.
Oh, my God.
a good team. I go in first, all sneaky-like, and get the lay of the land. Then you follow up with force, taking care of business. Of course, for a partnership, it's vital all parties profit in a venture. Now that's a right decent friend. This'll get me a bit closer to securing my ship. Sir Pain in my arse here tells me the Night Regent might be hiring new scouts as well. So I'll be heading back to Pridewyn. See you there.
No surprise there. Miss O'Malley gets what she wants and disappears. I do hope your courage accomplished more than padding her coin purse. I can only imagine the filth you had to wade through to reach the heart of the pirate's den. Did you find the foul sorcery Miss O'Malley claimed was there? Interesting. Perhaps that's why we're seeing even fewer of the scoundrels coming ashore than before. This revelation should be taken back to the Night Regent with all haste. I must keep vigil here. Ensure these scoundrels don't attempt any further incursions to the south. You must go alone, and go quickly. Use the spirit shrine to return to Pridewyn. It's a bit jarring, but time is of the essence.
Met such coordinated pirates? It's like they went to school or something. How will people ever find their way to Pridewyn if they can't even survive this beach? I was a baby and an absolute terror. Folks here say I used to leap out from behind trees and startle them. My bag had a fleur-de-lis, and I spoke a little French back then. Royal? Ha, hardly. I just want to make these pirates cry for their mothers. If only they didn't have so many weapons and barrels of gunpowder. Oh, what a good way to turn the barrels on them. Sneak up on the pirates, light their barrels, and then boom! Pirates blown to pieces! I'll keep watch here and make sure no one foils our grand plan. Gunpowder barrels. Had Sir Pain witnessed this, he might have even made you a squire. Wait, Sir Pain sees the spark of a knight in me. I have to train more, and fight more, and impress the regent. But you'll see, I'll become a knight soon. Then everyone will call me Sir Ash.
I can feel the party coming on already. We got wine and honey cakes. It's gonna be a feast.
You're a good person, Rajal Sadak. You're going to do very well here on Eternum. I hope to see more of you. Have you made friends here? You seem like someone a person would be lucky to call a friend. Back home in Syria, we always repay favors. You've helped me a lot. I hope I can return the favor. Words to live by, Rajal Sadak. You could be knight material, and I want to see you make it through a few more summers at least. Has anyone taught you how to make a sword? I suppose I must do everything around here. I'm sure that once I teach you to make a sword, you'll be able to supply armories. You have that industrious look about you. Fine looking sword, Rajal Sadak. You would almost rival the swords in Syria. I'm not surprised. It's what I've come to expect from you. Drop by at the tavern anytime you want to drink, all right? I'll tell you stories of the High King Artorias you wouldn't believe.
It is most excellent to see you return in good health. You are one of the few I can trust in these strange times. Your enterprising friend Grace left just moments ago. She said some foul altar was rallying the pirates. I think it is natural to assume this strange altar was somehow related to the tablet you found at Hiriath Peak. My sage, young geezer, has been studying the fragments you brought back. He believes they are ancient in origin. You have been here a short time, but perhaps you have seen the ruins yourself. Though humans have inhabited this island for thousands of years, there was a mysterious ancient civilization here even before we arrived. Many have sought answers to such questions, but few can claim to have reliable knowledge. One thing I do know, however, is that the lost usually stay away from the ruins of the ancients. It certainly appears that way. Though Sage Geezer insists this tablet was not buried at the mine, but rather planted there. You should converse with the Sage yourself. This new information may yield new insights. Please exercise discretion in speaking of these matters around town. The people are excited about the heir's return. I would not dampen their spirits.
course is a face I've not seen before. Aha! You're the newcomer who recovered these fragments from the mine. I am very excited to speak with you. This material is definitely ancient. Was there more in the pirate den to the north? An altar? Related to this tablet, then. Fascinating. Well, it couldn't have been there for long. There's only one possibility. All of this came from the ancient ruins of Caladan and Antares in the Eastern Wood. Yes! Only Minister Lochnia forbade me from going there. It's very dangerous, of course. But you, yes, you can go. Start with Caladan. Look for anything recently disturbed. Oh, and don't tell Lochnia.
It isn't the Night Regent's new page. On an errand even now, I presume. I am curious what merits such urgent attention when Jay's duty as regent so soon draws to an end. The Night Regent should not be conducting affairs she can't reveal to her people. Wouldn't you agree? I've served as Pridewen's minister since before her birth. I should be informed of this matter. You presume much, Page. I simply wish to convey any pressing matters to the true heir when he arrives. Keep your secrets, but know this. Pridewen will be united as never before to honor the royal bloodline. Nothing else matters.
sees when you're the reason your woman is no more. Even the moon burns you. Fatima's soul gave up on me. She came to me in a dream the other day and asked me to piece together this mirror. But I don't have all the fragments. Would you? Fatima said if I piece this mirror for her, she'll finally find peace. The peace I stole from her. Oh, we were so happy once. But all the sacrifices we made. Have you ever been with someone and yet felt so alone?
The ancients clearly have ways of controlling the guardians. I wonder if it's the same magic that powers the altars. I found runes here that light up when the lost come near them. Maybe there are more objects like these within the nearby ruins of Antares. So I shall continue my search there. For the true heir and the restoration of Pridewen's glory, we will find a way to unite behind the royal bloodline once again.
How does it feel to be alive, stranger? To know you cannot die? I used to dig graves in Bavaria, but obviously I couldn't do that here. I survived on scraps for a while, until I devised a new livelihood. I craft lost memorials from crystalline tears to soothe grieving families. Peace is always in demand. Many ask me for my services. But the crystalline tears are over, and so the tears of people must wait. You look more limber than me. You may have luck with these ruins. If you can brave the eldritch dangers and gather some crystalline tears for me, I'll give you a good portion of what I got from the families.
These altars in Caladan seem to have some sort of power over the lost. Power might be the wrong word, but definitely some kind of influence. I can use young Giza's notes to figure out how to channel their essence. And if I can't tap into their magic, maybe I can convey them to where they'll be most useful. The best thing is good.
Thank you.
many tears, such little time. You've done well by bringing these crystalline tears. You will be in the thoughts of many families when they say their final prayers for their kin.
There you are! I started to venture into those ruins after you, but I lost my nerve when I caught sight of those guardians. I hope you found something in there to make it worth your while. Ha! I'd wager it'll be the first and last time you hear Grace O'Malley say this, but just now, I am on official business. The Night Regent sent me to track you down. She says we need your help figuring out what's going on. Just after you left Pridewin, that wide-eyed Minister Lochnir started acting strange, shouting around town that the true heir's arrival was upon us. He led some knights and even some townsfolk down south to welcome the new king. I'd say there's no doubt about that. I tailed the bastard and his entourage. They marched straight into a crowd of the lost. The Night Regent says Lochnir's gone mad. She wants you to come help as soon as you're done here. Then I suppose I'll be waiting for you. The Night Regent told me not to return without you. Get on with whatever you're doing. And if you find any treasure in the ruins, don't forget your dear friend Grace.
Gracias, kind soul. Fatima always loved her mirrors. With this last fragment, she could have her final one. She said mirrors have a certain magic to them. And I can sense the energy in this. Almost a strange calling. Thank you.
Did you find anything else in there relating to the minister's plans? Well, I'll be damned if that doesn't explain a lot of the queer happenings around here. I suppose that's how he's able to walk freely among those blue-eyed rotters as well. With that revelation, I'd say it's all the more urgent that you catch up with the Night Regent. She wants you to meet her at the last of the farms that hasn't fallen to the lost. It's not too far from here. She left Sir Payne in charge of Pridewind's defenses. She wanted to see to these troubles personally. I suspect the Night Regent's looking to draw steel against Lochnir herself. You best get going. The Night Regent asked me to circle down to the pirate dens further south, see what's happening there. I'll catch up with you at the farm soon enough.
I cannot express how reassuring it is to have your presence down here. As much respect as I've always had for Minister Locke, it is painfully clear that he's suddenly gone quite mad. Is that what you discovered in the ruins? Was Lochnir behind the strange tablet at the mine? The pirates, too. I am having trouble understanding what his ultimate goal is, or if he even has one. I question everything the minister said now. But apparently the knights at Tiernan Keep met Sir Gawain. Priscilla here was a knight there herself until recently. I believe she's hiding something. You should speak to her.
Well met, stranger. The Night Regent said you have been her only reliable counsel in recent days. For your service to her and to Pridewind, I salute you. I was a knight myself, not long ago. Yes? When the farms in these parts started falling to the lost, the town's supplies were threatened. I volunteered to take over this farm to ensure Pridewind did not go hungry. It was a difficult decision. It was not long after I left Tiernan Keep that my fellow knights there fell to becoming lost as fell. If I overheard correctly, you found proof that Lochnir planned all of this? That explains much. I know the minister had planned to claim the Circlet of Swords, the royal crown of Monarch's Bluffs from Tiernan Keep. If he can control the lost knights there, I suppose that's how he'll do it. I suspect it's already too late, and My fellow knights still defend the keep as firmly as ever. I'd advise against going. There's nothing there but death and grief. But perhaps you may discover more of Lochnir's plan. No. I will not raise my blade against my fellow knights, even in the state they're in. I will give you this seal, however. You'll also need the seals of the other knights to access the sacred chamber inside the keep.
As royal ladies, we've always been protected. We led lavish lives in the Chosun court, and for a while, in Ebonscale Reach. It's the first time we're living out in the wilds, like common folk. We're trying to adapt. Yes. Once upon a time, I was even destined to be queen. But I lost my betrothed to the sea, on our way to the island. My mother hasn't given up hope I will be married one day. She fears the worst if I don't. That I'll turn into a lost. Like the ones who haunt this island. A creature with no purpose but to haunt women with better prospects. Mother grew up with tales of the virgin ghost. It's hard to shake her out of her belief. Are you betrothed to anyone? I'm struggling to convince Nabi to get married. She mustn't meet a horrendous fate. I wouldn't be able to live with myself.
Show me your smile.
Oh, your teeth are radiant.
Do you use miswak to brush them? In the Ottoman Empire, everyone had good teeth. Here? Not so much. Here, people eat whatever they get. More days than a snail has teeth. I left to pursue my great ideas in my reckless youth. I still feel as reckless and almost as young. And if I can get enough wolf teeth, I'll finally be able to craft my invention. I already have 26 pearly white wolf fangs. I need 6 more, just like them. They should be from robust middle-aged wolves. Warriors, if you can spot them. Could you get the teeth for me? I'll be grateful.
I've been ruined. I can't work like I once used to. Oh, what good are hands when your mind is occupied by the demons that plague your dreams. Oh, scars. My father's mistakes wore him down till he broke. He always thought the world was better. He shattered when he saw the truth. He lost himself in making glassworks. People came from all over the island to buy them. He had a deep relationship with glass, knew exactly which mineral would elicit the color he desired. His works were treasures that brought hope. But now, they're lost in a house filled with horrors. Would you? I can't step foot in that house. There are too many memories. It isn't easy to be second place in your father's eyes. Please, just get the glassworks, if you can.
Thank you.
Look how they fall in line when they realize something greater than them is at their doorstep. It will be the same with corruption.
Getting into the house must not have been easy. I am grateful for your courage. These are the last things I have of my father. At least he got to spend his last days with his precious work. He wrote me letters. I'll read his words, although I am fearful of what they may reveal. Isn't it ironic that my emotions are as fragile as his glass? At least his works have value.
You spotted the wolves well. Middle-aged, strong. Aggressive fighters, most likely.
Oh, these are the perfect fangs. They're sparkly, they're white. They can cut through meat.
The first of its kind dental weapon for the toothless elderly among us. Those who have the punch, but lack the bite. One chomp from these pearly beauties will make an attacker regret the choices. Brilliant, no?
You ventured into Tirnan Keep and returned with your soul intact? You are indeed as worthy as the Night Regent claimed. I trust you discovered that Lochnir had already taken the crown. I suspected as much. Oh, God's blood. I cannot bear the burden of this dark secret anymore. I was there, and I witnessed when Lochnir brought Sir Gawain for us to swear loyalty. The minister told us we would be honored to be the first to kneel before the new king. But when he ushered Sir Gawain into the keep, we realized the true heir was lost himself. We were aghast, speechless. The minister reminded us of our sworn duty to the royal bloodline. He told us the sacrifice of becoming lost was noble and right. Then he lined us up and killed us one by one. I faltered. I couldn't do it, so I fled. I was ashamed, unwilling to join them in soullessness, but also unwilling to betray my comrades in the bloodline. I regret it now. I should have come to the Night Region sooner. Perhaps I could have prevented all this. All right. It is my duty. The Night Regent has returned to Prydwen, but we can try to stop Lochnir down here. A scout was sent southward. You should seek them out. Once I dig up my armor, I will join you. And friend, thank you.
Wedding rings and love letters. So some of the lost used to be married once? That makes no sense. And you're saying that even getting married doesn't keep you from turning into one of these creatures? How disturbing. A talisman to ward off evil spirits. What a clever idea. Why don't you use the wedding rings? Maybe they'll influence Nabi, and she'll want to get married sooner. Talisman.
then? To protect me from evil and lower my chances of turning into a ghost? Does this mean my mother no longer believes marrying is protection against turning into the lost? And my mother will always want that. If she ever turned into a lost, which I hope she never does, she'd follow me around with the sole purpose of getting me married. And probably scare all my suitors away.
Goodness, I found someone I can report to. And better it's not the Night Regent. Remember all those lost pirates swarming around that den to the north? That was a small affair compared to this place. Good old Minister Lochnir was here, sure enough. There's another one of those glowing altars, but this time I don't think he's meaning to draw the pirates in, but rather send them forth. The rotten bastards are loading up their ships with explosives as we speak. I'd wager they're sailing for Prydwen as soon as he gives word. They'll blast the town from here to Connacht. Well, we've discussed this partnership before, haven't we? I get the lay of the land, and you do the battling part. You'll be facing long odds, but you're like a lucky anchor. I'd consider making a wager on you, regardless. Not a problem. I'll always tell it to you straight. I'd suggest you destroy as many explosives as you can, and take out that glowing altar too. Now, what would you have me do? Now there's an order I don't mind following. I could use a cup of mead after all this crawling around. I'll go and tell the Night Regent what's what, but my hopes go with you. It's better if these bastards never set sail.
Oh. folly we have committed. We unleashed the most tragic magic by giving in to Fatima's whims. We made a talking mirror that berates me for my decisions every minute, every hour, every day. It just doesn't stop. I had to. Her words are still pounding in my head. I broke her heart, and now I've broken her mirror. Maybe that's why she won't stop haunting me. See, I do. Fatima was the joy of my soul once. I left Spain, left my family because of my love for her. I love my querida even when we fought, even when her cloudy gray eyes turned into a storm. You are right. She speaks through another large mirror in the cove that's filled with pirates. I'll need your help to break it, but I must get her taunts out of my head.
So she spoke the truth after all. That Grace character told me you'd gone in there on your own, but I had to see it to believe it. I heard the ruckus and saw the smoke. Am I to assume that means your mission was a success? Yeah. There's cause for celebration. It's even tempting to take the good news to Brightwind right away. But I believe there's an opportunity to strike a critical blow against the enemy here and now. Sir Gawain and his court of lost knights are not far. They're fortified in his ancestral home across the water, Corbinic Castle. I suspect that's where Lochnir has led his unfortunate followers as well. Yes, though we need a plan. They have the Circlet of Swords, and an army of Lost has already fallen under Sir Gawain's influence. Defeating a Knight of Legend will be hard enough, but won't he just return to command them again? Is that how that Greywind madman controls the Lost? Yes. It makes sense now. I thought perhaps it was Gawain's royal blood. But now, I see. This whole thing is a contrivance of Lochnir's.
How is it that you could love someone, and yet living with them can slowly destroy you? This island didn't help. Oh, Fatima, I miss you so much.
Thank you. Hello, friend. I hope this day is treating you with kindness. Would you have time to help a fellow? Regrettably, the people I was trying to protect have turned into the lost. May fortune be with you. I'd come to the settlement to find help, but no one had time to listen. It takes a special person to go out of their way to help someone else. Did you find everyone's amulets? Thank you, friend. You have put my mind at ease. The problems on this island are larger than those I've experienced, and one can't use their hand to force the sun to set. I hope you keep an open heart on this island. I fear it's too late for me. One who has been bitten by a snake lives in fear of worms.
Well, here we are. This is the moment of truth. If we fail here, the Lost will overrun Prideven and everyone in it. I don't know what defenses this tower possesses, but it is clearly well fortified, and Lochnir has undoubtedly taken precautions. I would expect heavy resistance. Your courage is unquestionable, and I've witnessed your prowess in battle. You're a force to be reckoned with. But if I'm being honest, I'd prefer not to take up arms against my former comrades, nor the heir of Artorias. Thank you. I will defend this position to ensure none come to the castle's defense, and that Lochnir does not escape. Defeat those villains, destroy that damn staff, and reclaim the crown. I look forward to your triumphant return.
Thank you.
think I've been holding my breath since you departed. Or at least it feels that way. Tell me, did you defeat Sir Gawain and destroy Lochnir's infernal staff? Praise to whatever gods are at your back. I feel like I'm waking from a long nightmare. My thrill at learning of the true heir's return was only matched by the horror of learning what he had become. After this, perhaps we should consider abandoning this obsession with restoring the royal bloodline. We can't return the circlet of swords to Tir Nun Keep anyhow. I think we should return it to Prytwyn. Yes. Though Jay is bound by her duty. She'd make an excellent queen, but she can't even imagine such a thing. I suspect the court training of her youth is to blame. Her humility will be yet another formidable foe. Yes. We'll speak to the people. We'll tell them the truth about Lochnir and the heir. The crown deserves to be worn by a noble ruler. A ruler like Jin Jay. I'll see you in Prytwyn, comrade.
Really? You found something that belonged to my family? What is it? Who are they? Where can I meet them? Ooh, give me that! She was a prestigious knight in the time of Arturius himself. I can't believe it. This knight business runs in my blood. Thank you for bringing this to me. I'm going to keep it as a reminder.
You've stopped the lost conquest of this kingdom. I have to wonder, are you sure you've really helped these people?
Word of your victory has already breached the walls, and we are extremely grateful. I welcome you back to Prytwyn as a hero. I can never repay the debt this town owes to you. I'm not sure. I do not have royal blood, but I suppose we've learned that the bloodline is now cursed. Strangely enough, your friend Grace suggested the same thing just before she left. We were in the tavern after word of your success, and someone mentioned a shipbuilder in Oxborough. She was so eager to meet this person she left right away. She did ask me to tell you, of course. I would understand if you wish to follow and seek adventure to the north yourself. Otherwise, I do have Sir Payne and Sir Priscilla. But I could always use more knights, especially if I am to become queen. Yes, after careful consideration, I realize it is the honorable thing. It is the ultimate requirement of my sworn duty. Will you stay then, and serve Prytwyn at my side, or do voices call you elsewhere? You hear the voice of corruption? There are legends of its insidious torment. You must be bearing such a burden. In the days of Artorius, they say it was the voice of Murden that called the knights to darkness. It drove them mad. I know of no cure, but there's an old man who comes to Prytwyn now and then. He warns about corruption. Some say he's deranged, but I see wisdom in his eyes. He fishes the East River. You should seek him out.
Oh.
true heir sought to save us once, and now the answer they'll bring. The lost will learn, be forever turned. They'll know them as our one true king.